Hey YouTubers, welcome to Millennium Falcon Diorama Update number 10. And in this show, well, it's fairly late at night, but Mama Smurf's in there radically updating the kitchen. So we don't have to be way quiet. She's on one of her radical attack modes to update the kitchen, and there's no point in me even going in there because I'll just get, like, assaulted with a spray can or something. So what we've been doing this week is really working on that bottom hall section. And the bottom hall is not quite as detailed as that top hall section, but it is very well detailed. And it's far more lighted, actually, because that's where all the landing light array is. And the landing lights also in the landing gear. And also, gosh, there's also some forward landing lights in the forward part below the mandible. Lots and lots of stuff. For a kit that is actually termed as being not much lighted, there's a lot of lighting in the Millennium Falcon, to be honest with you. So we've got that going to be shown to you. And I've been working on that for this week, and I wanted to show that to you tonight. It's one of those nights where I have the energy to do so. It is November 3rd today, and although we've been expecting this cold weather to kick in and all that, not doing it. Daytona Beach here lately today was hot, almost in the 90s, and I am thoroughly sick of it. I want some cool weather, and I've had the AC running all day, and I know for you guys up north where it's already getting cold, whatever, I don't know if it's been snowing up there, I haven't been keeping up with it, but oh my God, give me a break, you know. It's like the summers here last for 9-10 months. It's just ridiculous. We've had some years here where we literally don't have a winter. It's warm through and through. I love summertime, but a little break here and there is very nice. What else? Oh, and I did start, as I mentioned, a paranormal investigation business sort of thing. It's called paranormaltech.net. Couldn't get the com. Somebody else had the com, damn it. If you want to check it out, it's a small site. It's only 3 pages long. I can make it as big as I want to with GoDaddy or not. But really, it's something that, because it's only in the vicinity of Daytona, out towards a diameter towards Orlando, which is 60 to 70 miles. I didn't want to go completely hog wild with it. But it's for people that are actually experiencing some kind of supernatural events because of the Indian burial grounds and all that, where all these homes have been built upon, where I know from people telling me that things happen. And I'm not talking about every home in every neighborhood. I mean, it's sparsed out. But there are things happening in certain homes where people are like, what the heck's going on in this house? For some reason, there are some regions that are more, you know, where it's happening in more states than certain others, although I would imagine there's a fair amount of distribution in all states. For some reason, some of the states where the Indian tribes were in conflict with the white man more than in others, these things tend to be more intense. And if you want us to come out and check out your place, if you have something that you're, you know, really concerned about and is bugging you and you just can't get a heads or tails about it, you've got the plumbers out, you've got electricians out, and, you know, you've had friends over and they're like, well, we'll see you again sometime and it'll never come back. Or you're at work thinking like, you know, what is going on? And you keep thinking about it. We're not the worst people you can call over there. I've had quite a lot of experience with it. And if you watch the video, I'll tell you some other things that I'm able to gather in those kind of situations. Don't want to get too far into it. So anyways, back to the Millennium Falcon. The Millennium Falcon right now is fully lighted as far as the bottom spectrum of the landing lights. I haven't put in the landing gear yet with its lighting, but I'll show you how it's prepped and ready to be installed with the landing lighting. What else? Also, the you know, the alcoves or the indents with all the little extra piping and all that, they have their fiber optic details and what not. and then we'll show you what's coming up. This guy's coming along. Now, as far as, you know, I've been saying it's 70%, 80%, whatever. That is assembly-wise. Now, when we get to the painting start, we're back to zero again, but that will go much faster. When I get that old airbrush out and my paints out and all that, that is not a long period. To fully detail the Millennium Falcon and really get it looking the way I think it should be looking, it's probably no more than 2 to 4 weeks, somewhere in between in there, depending how well it goes. Considering the cool weather's coming in, I won't have the old gummy paint situation that we have in the summertime. Then we're up to the point of doing the diorama. Now the diorama, of course, is of Mos Eisley. There will be a study of frames. I will try to do as much as, you know, it's a 360 degree area, obviously, on film. Even though probably the set was about 240 degrees, I'm going to do about a 120 to 180 degree capture of that set with the Millennium sitting in the center of it. It is what's called a screen capture. This is what I do. I take the frame and I render a presentation for the client inside a display case of that frame best as I can. We have figures for the frame and all, everything's going to be in scale and whatever. And very, very pretty. Mostly made of scaled foam inserts, sometimes some putty and whatever. Going to be cool. I promise it's going to be cool. There's some lighting involved. There's some landing light stuff there. There's a little tunnel. There's some alcoves or little overlooks here and there and whatever. According to that diagram. And I'm also going to look at some stills from the film itself. This is from A New Hope. And we'll go from there. And then there's the funny. Now, the funny has to be explained. As you know, in the last funny, the professor vaporized the pool at her. And he did a heck of a job. All there was left was the imprint and the pool pump. Well, the professor I went looking for, yes, in the backyard, and I couldn't find him. The professor has these little gadgets, and I don't exactly know how he does it, but he can travel through time like Doctor Who. And although he has not too many options where and when and all that, I know he can do it. And he went to somewhere that I created in the future, or at least found, I don't know about created, called The Smurf Dome, as you know, is a website that I've created. Well, The Smurf Dome is something I created, but really, it's more something that I found. And for you guys to actually understand fully what's going to be seen here in this videotape is you have to join The Smurf Dome, which means you have to have a Facebook account. Now, I'm going to show you the video, what happened, which is captured. It's literally the professor getting into one of these quadcopter things, which is in 3245, which is the time frame in which the Smurf Dome is occurring. It's kind of complicated. It's time travel stuff back and forth. Yeah, it's very complicated. And he goes to visit somebody that runs the dome at least below level 42. Again, very complicated. And, well, unless you're in the Smurf Dome, you really won't completely understand it, and he'll tell you. And I'm sorry, guys. I mean, after all the hundreds of videos I've shown you where you completely, hopefully, got the gist of the joke, you may not get this one. And although I'm not striving to drive you into the Smurf Dome, I only have so many time to do a funny. I only have so much time to do film. And over the Halloween holidays, I did this one specifically for the domers, and it was rather good. And it's funny, even if you don't really quite completely get the whole thing, but it's based on a premise that in the dome right now, there's been an alien invasion. And the domers don't quite know what to do. The professor showed up from here with that laser weapon he vaporized my pool with. And he escaped from me by going through the time travel thing. And it ended up in the dome. He was arrested. They tried to take his weapon away. And then he stole one of their flying machines and went to this particular place that I don't want to mention. I don't want to ruin it for you. And this is what happened. Again, you won't get the full gist of it unless you join the Smurf Dome. Now, I gotta be honest with you, the Smurf Dome is a private adult closed group. If you try to join a Smurf Dome, you go in there, but you don't talk about what goes on in there. It's like people want to be able to say what they want to say in there. It's private, okay? You can say whatever you want, but you don't come out of there and say, well, so-and-so said this and so-and-so said that. It's not about... But it's the video is still a little bit funny. If you join, it'd be even more funny because I actually make videos for the Smurf Dome that are not seen anywhere else. And the Smurf Dome is privy to seeing my videos and certain like early leaks of videos or actual photographs and all that of my projects before anybody else, or even stuff that's never seen anywhere else. So if you're really into what I do, it's a great place to be. There are like 7 or 8 primes in there, which are kind of like mods, but they're a lot cooler than mods. Mods suck. The primes are in charge of, you know, checking out whoever wants to come in. And if you belong to certain groups that we don't particularly care for, and have been problems for us in the past, you could have a problem with that. But if you're like, you know, you're pretty hip and you're into like strange stuff, it's kind of like... a little bizarre, and a lot of weird stuff gets posted there. We got space vampire killer bunnies, we've got aliens, you know. There's a running theme story that goes on in there. It's kind of like immersive Dungeons and Dragons sort of thing, but not exactly. It's also just a plain posting thing where you can show your work and all that. It's pretty trippy. It's something I came up with a long time ago when I realized that all these, basically, these science fiction groups are rather dull, really, you know, and this is something totally different. So, I wish I could give a sampler, but it's not like that. So anyway, so now we'll move on. I'll show you what I'm doing on the bottom hall of the Millennium Falcon. You've already seen what I did on the top. And then I'll blow the funny at you. And it is kind of funny. And it'd be a lot funnier if you join the Smurf Dome. Although we're not looking for numbers. We're looking for people that are into what we're into. And if you are, then I think you'll enjoy it. If it's like something that you find distasteful or it's a little too much for you, you just don't get it, then you know, hard feelings, man. You know, it's like you don't have to join, or if you join, you don't like it, then hey, just say so. But, you know, I'm PG on these particular films and all that, but sometimes it's nice to let loose and do films where I can use copyrighted music and not worry about it, or go a little nuts beyond what I do on these films and not worry about it, and let my creative flow go a little bit beyond the PG realm. So let's move on. All right, so here on the very messy workbench, and yes, I'm doing this video on the fly a whole lot tonight. This is actually what it looks like. Resistors and soldering irons and all kinds of things on the bench tonight. This is the bottom hull. Notice that some of the past details you've already seen. Also notice now that you have all the lighting gear available. Let me close up here a little bit. Let me see if I can do this relatively smoothly. There we go. And I think it's hooked up. Yeah. There we go. You can kind of see it lit up. Now I'm going to go ahead and turn off the lights and see how that goes. Now what I did choose is on the red ones, I chose the flashers. They are kind of cool. They are offset in timing. And there you go. So what these are ambers, red, ambers, and then large ambers right near the airlocks. And these are the puppies that are going to be seen when I flip this upside down. And of course, with everything else, that's going to be seen. And I think this is coming out. I'm having a rough time with the screen. But with everything else that's going to be seen up top, this is what's going to be underneath here. The screen, really. Unless you're seeing at the right angle, you are not seeing exactly what you need to see. There you go. So that's the underneath part. So now I'm going to go ahead and turn the lights back on. And let's give you a look. Now the landing gear, which we go into place, let me show you a Still got paint all over my fingers. Now, this is the landing gear. Let me see if I can get here and then scale. Now, there are retention pins that were on either side. And these retention pins were so you could remove the landing gear or put it back in. Well, this is not going to be the case since this is a diorama. The landing gear will be in there permanently. Notice that there are now three apertures. Now, these will either be large fiber optics or very small LEDs that will be shining in through the bottom, lighting up those lighting bay areas. And in the case of the smaller ones, the smaller landing bay on either end. And these guys go in respectively. And the skid is aiming towards the front. In these areas right here. So that's where those guys are going to be. And again, more lighting. So again, for a kit that most people associate as being not very much lit, a lot of lighting, actually. And a good thing that Rodrigo decided to go with non-self-encapsulated lighting power, because at this point, I would have run out of 9-volt battery power quite a while back. So this power system is going to be based on the Millennium Falcon actually being powered up by a clip connector in the actual diorama, which is a good thing, Rodrigo, good idea. And I told you, I think a couple of videos back, that we were like really going to have to be reaching to have the 9-volt power all the lighting that I finally discovered was existing in this Millennium Falcon, especially when the engine's turned on, because that pretty much wipes out a whole battery. Crazy videotape from a place no one should ever go. And you guys let me know. And if anybody wants to join the Smurfdome and thinks they got what it takes to go into that hellhole, let me know. Things noisy. Hey, Big D, what's up? Well, I did land a futuristic craft in the foothills. Yeah, I'm sorry. Well, it was an unplanned event. I thought I really needed to tell you things. Well, hey, man, I'm not trying to, crash on your party or anything. I didn't realize you had 1,000 virgins in there. I'm very sorry about that. No, man, hey, just take a little break, I'm sure there'll be 999. Why? Well, because one of the demons will have eaten one by the time you get back. Whoa! No, don't get upset. No, it's okay. Listen, back in 3245, you remember that? Yeah, I know, it's not super interesting, but still. Your boys are running that dome thing. You remember what you told me? All that ugliness? Yes. Well, aliens have showed up. Did you know about that? No. No, I didn't think you did. Yeah, that little gray guys. Yeah, is that a little Eli? Yeah. Hey, who would have known, Hey, they're mischievous, I always thought they were Santa's elves, but they were just abducting me and doing, nasty things I don't want to talk about. Hey, it was 33, I was 13 years old. What do you want? Anyways, they're talking with your boys downstairs. They're wearing suits, trying to be really, really cool and all. And, I think they're working out some kind of deal, and I think you're getting shafted, man. Whoa! Hey, look, man, I'm just looking out for your interest. I'm your buddy, right? Okay, I'm not your buddy. Well, I'm just trying to stay out of here for a while. Own preserving self-interest kind of thing. And yeah, you can dig that, right? Yeah, exactly.
yeah, you know, I'm just trying to imitate the master. Oh, I'm not worthy, I'm not worthy. Yeah, great movie. Hey, you're hip, man. I like that. Well, anyways, so I just came by to drop off to tell you, man, at 3245. I don't think this was like along the timeline, you know, and the time police, well, sometimes they miss things. The time police. Yeah, you remember them guys. No, even you can't mess with them guys. I'm sorry, the big guy. Oh, yeah. The other guy. Yeah, take it easy. You know, the other guy that's not as good as you. Oh, you like that. Okay, the other guy is not as good as you, but, you know, it's kind of a similar position, even though he's not as good as you. Jesus. Anyways, this other guy, he met his soul at the time police, didn't answer to anyone. It's not your fault. Yeah, and they don't know about these guys. So they are beyond the control of anyone, okay? I don't take it personal. Yes, even the Mormons. Yes, I know. It's crazy. No, I know it's a bunch of bullshit. Sorry, kids. Anyway, we don't know what to do. So I thought I'd let you know, because they're all over the air docks, and these people are having a lot of trouble, and they want me to shoot down the mothership. And I got a feeling that's going to lead to bad things. Yes, I don't think that's going to be a very good idea. No, I don't think so. What do you think? None of my bloody business. Well, hey, you're up to your usual prankster self. Yes, I see you're in good spirits. Listen, I'm going to get back in my little flying machine and then trying to find a way out of this. Can you help me? Maybe. And I'll take that as a possible yes-no kind of thing. Okay, well, take that. Well, first, go have some fun with the, what is it now? 84 virgins. Boy, they're hungry in there. You know, you should feed them more often. Oh, okay. Hey, I'm just having fun, really. Really big D. Don't take offense, okay? I'm a funny guy. Oh, I think I'm a funny guy. Yeah. Okay, all right. Oy. All right, well, back to the flying thingy. Boys and girls, if you haven't joined the Smurf Dome, consider it, but you've got to have a pretty sick sense of humor to be there. If not, well, just take it as a sort of a funny you didn't get. You know, I put out like 200-something funnies that you got. Oh, well, you know. Life goes on, kids. All right, so having a wonderful day. Auf Wiedersehen. This is Professor Manfred von Zippenstein. Somewhat at your service. God, I hope they haven't eaten the copter.